Christmas, everybody! Yes, it's that wonderful time of year again! So welcome to the Glitzy Gourmet Christmas Special Show! Let's hope Denise is home, because I know she would want to show you what a wonderful job she did decorating her home this year. You have to excuse Santa, I have a cold, plus my nose is peeling.
So once we get them in the bag, you're going to have to crush them when you're bagging them. But you've got to kind of bag with the pointed part of this to get them to really crush up. I'm going to do all of this in the microwave. I find it a lot easier when you do this anyway because you do it in the microwave. You can get a glass bowl or any microwave bowl. We're going to put these chocolates in there. Chocolate in the microwave and get them melted. I first set it for 45 seconds, and then we'll mix it up and see how it's doing. These are great things to make up, put in little bags and give out as favors, even in a candy dish for people to pick on. It's really like a nice combination with the chocolate, the dark chocolate. So as you can see, the first 45 seconds didn't do too much, so we're going to put it back in again for maybe about like 20. We don't want to overdo it, so I'd rather do it slowly and then just keep mixing. Before I start to spread that, I want to put the white chocolate in so we can start to get that melted. And it's the same thing. We'll start with 45 seconds and work our way from there. Now, as the white chocolate's melted, we're going to spread the dark chocolate on our wax paper. cutting this dry to spread it, and it's like an even thickness. You don't want it real, real thick, and you don't want it too thin either. Because then you want to be able to crack it apart. So this size cookie pan is just about a good size to spread it around. And that was one bag of the chocolate. Check on our white. And as you can see, the first round of the white is just about halfway. Now we can start to mix it a little. And we're going to just put this right back in again for another 20. Take the peppermint candies. Like I said, if you can see the consistency, there are little chunks, but most of it is like a powder, and that's what you want, because you want to get that peppermint flavor through the white. We're going to dump this into the white chocolate. Spread this on top on the chocolate. Go right to the edge if you can. Chocolate. This batch I'm going to make with the milk chocolate, but I've also made it with gets to this type of a consistency. You might see a few little bumps still, but it's okay. You can add in your condensed milk, and it's one can of the sweetened condensed milk. This will make it even easier to, like, mix it together, too. This is one you can kind of get creative with your fudge, too, if you like. You can add marshmallows and make it like a rocky road. You can add some raisins. You can add coconut. You can get creative and add just about anything you want. Looks good. See how it's getting, like, shiny and looking? All right. So now we're going to put this. It's going to fit in two little foil pans about this size. And first we want to line them with wax paper too. That way when it's done, it makes it a lot easier to get the fudge out of the pan to cut. Put this here. Thank you. then, like, take it out for a little bit in the morning, and then you can cut it. So let's get these guys in the refrigerator. And you can put them in on top of each other like this. They won't stick. They'll be fine. Let's get these in the refrigerator, too. Okay. So I've cheated. I already made some boxes at the time. So I'm going to be able to push it. When I was making it, I tried experimenting with different things, and I tried putting some, like, crunchier peppermint on top of it, and it didn't work out good, because when I went to crack it, it was all falling off. So, like I said in the beginning, crush the peppermint's really good, and make it almost more like a powdery, and I think it'll absorb into the chocolate a lot better. So, let's start cracking this. I think I'm going to try to use this now. Little bags at the dollar store, which I think is right. And when we crush it, I just put them in the little bags, tie them up, and give them all his favors. Turn this over. I find it easier to cut on this side than the other side. You just kind of go back and forth. I make them about an inch by an inch. Okay. this big and easy to cut. If you just take it out and try to cut it right away, it's really kind of hard. You just want it that not freezing, freezing cold. These are great. You can give these even as gifts. You can get little boxes and put them in boxes. You can put them just in these and wrap them up. People love fudge, especially if it's homemade. And it's easy enough to make with kids, too. It doesn't take a long time, so they don't lose interest while they're helping you cook. Let's add a little bit of the bark. I'm going to get this.